So I'm back at the workshop, and this morning I spotted something rather interesting. It's a little motorbike in the garage next door. It's like one of those monkey bikes from the 1960s. You know, the ones with the tiny wheels. They're a bit of a cold item. You know what? There could be some money to be made if I can buy one at the right price from my neighbour, Dickie.
This is the one. This little monkey bike down here, look.
Oh, yeah, I like these.
Hey, Dickie.
How you doing?
Hi.
I just thought I'd show Elvis your little bike collection. You've got quite a few bits, haven't you?
Yeah, we have a bit.
Yeah, hey, Dickie.
Mark.
All right.
How are you doing?
I really like this little monkey
bike. Yeah, nice
bike.
Little bike. I was going to restore it.
Would you?
Might still do that, yeah.
Is it original?
No, I don't think so.
I don't think that engine's original. That's had an upgrade.
Is it?
A bit bigger. But that's not necessarily a bad thing.
No, it's not a bad thing. No, it looks good, doesn't it?
Honda launched a monkey bike in the 1960s as an amusement park ride. And when they developed a road-legal version, their popularity exploded. John Lennon's monkey bike sold for over £57,000 at an auction in 2018. I'm hoping this one is a lot cheaper.
How much is this worth?
Don't know. Grand? I'll take grand for it.
You want a Rio for this?
Oh, I do.
Come on, Dick.
A grand! We take 700 quid for it?
No. Make it nine. 900 quid, it's yours.
£900.
Goodness
done.
Me.
Sorted. You happy
well
with
done.
That?
Yeah, well, happy. Lovely. So now we own a really cool retro bike. It needs a little bit of work rather than a straight-up restoration. And I reckon we could do something more unusual to reflect its personality. Change the colour, add some unique touches.
It's all right, isn't it?
I mean, I do like it.
I do.
I think there's quite a bit we can do to it. There are chips and scratches all over this. So I think we could go for a respray on it.
I agree.
I mean, I'd go complete a world away from where it is now and bring it more modern, make it really stand out. Something like a deep red.
Because you have to think of the person who would buy this. Somebody who's got a disposable income that just wants to have something they can have a bit of fun with.
Well, whoever buys it is going to want to show it off to their mates.
Of course they are.
Something that no one else is going to have. So let's make it unique. I mean, even the seat, you know, let's get rid of that fairly boring, dull standard seat and let's cover it in something. This is exciting. I don't often get total free reign to create something one-off and unique. Don't worry, though, I'm not going to cover it in animal print or anything like that. I am, though, going to come up with a unique idea. But I've got plenty to do while I ever think about it. So if we're going to repaint this whole thing, the whole lot needs to be stripped so we can get access to it. So that means the saddle's got to come off, the mudguards, handlebars, the whole lot. Instead of having a kind of steel tubular frame that most motorbikes have with a fairing then over the top, this is a pressed steel frame. So this blue part is actually the frame itself. That's what we're going to be stripping back and repainting. So it is a little bit unusual, I guess. These bikes got their nickname from the unusual riding position, bent over with arms outstretched in front. I think that's about it. Well, the monkey bike is small, that means everything's hard to get to, but I've managed to strip it right down, and now the next thing is getting it painted. You need a well-ventilated room for resprays, and it's best to wear a high-quality mask and all-in-one suit. I've hung the bike, so I've got good access to those hard-to-reach places. Three coats of red colour and one of clear lacquer create the perfect finish. While the bike frame dries, I'm getting to grips with that black vinyl saddle.
So I've been having a bit of a think about how we can make our monkey bike stand out from the crowd. So I've had this idea, but I want to recover it in something a bit different. And I've been to a charity shop and found one of those rugged old wax jackets. And I thought about cutting that up and using it to recover the saddle. So I'm on my way now to see an upholsterer called Dave to see if he thinks he might be able to make it reality.
Dave?
Hi.
Hi, mate, it's Elvis.
Hi, how are
you? I spoke
doing?
On the phone.
Yes,
yeah, I'm all right. This is the monkey bike saddle. I found this wax jacket in a charity shop, and I would like to chop that up and use it to cover this.
Is it possible?
Yes.
Yeah.
I'd quite like to incorporate some of the features of it. A pocket, you know, something that makes it obviously a jacket and a bit different.
So my first thought was, I like this double-corded section.
Yeah.
We can add some more detail down the sides.
So you take other bits like pocket flaps and add them on top?
Exactly, yeah.
I love coming to meet people like Dave because I know I'm getting something absolutely unique. There's not going to be another monkey bike in the world with a funky saddle like this one. When do you reckon it might be ready?
I would think it'll be ready in the next day or so.
Yeah. Tomorrow?
Go on then. Why not?
OK. Thanks, mate. No, I can't wait to see it. Okay. I love it. That is amazing. It's brilliant. It's just got loads of little features. He's put little poppers off the jacket all over it. That's exactly what I was hoping for. So I better get it on it.
A new saddle cover would cost around £100. We spent the same money, but ended up with something totally bespoke.
It looks brilliant. I love it. Well, Mike gave me almost total free rein to do whatever I wanted with a monkey bike, to express myself, and that's exactly what I've done. It's a little bit different, a little bit unusual.
No way. That's not the same little monkey bike, is
it? I know. Isn't it amazing? What a transformation. Do you like it?
What? No, that's not.
I promise you it's the same one.
Look at that saddle. That saddle's fantastic.
You like that?
I love it.
I chopped up an old wax jacket, made the seat cover.
I love it. You even left the pocket on it. Yeah. What a nice little touch.
I need a new coat, but it looks great, doesn't it?
It's lovely. I mean, it's absolutely gorgeous. Oh, well, look, I'm going to a motor show. I'm going to pack that up and take it with me. I reckon I'll get it sold.
Yeah, I reckon you will too.
Classic car shows are hugely popular now, attracting traders selling anything from motor memorabilia to vintage clothes. It's the perfect shop window for our retro bike. I'm going to put it up for £2,000.
How you doing, chaps? You all right?
What's the story of this?
This is my nice little Honda. It's like a retro Honda monkey bike. It's fully restored, yeah. Everything's running, driving beautifully. If you're interested, let me know.
I might do, yeah.
Thanks, bub. Cheers. So the little monkey bike has generated quite a bit of interest. I've had loads of people looking at it.
Oh, no, it's good. Sounds lovely.
It's gone up in value a lot recently, but nobody's willing to do a deal just yet.
Really nice, isn't it? It's lovely.
I met this chap earlier, and he's back for a second look. Sure sign he's interested.
Yeah, I've been thinking about this one.
Have you?
Yeah.
Nice. I mean, we've done a complete restoration on it. It's really nice. We've even done some modifications to the saddle.
This used to be a wax coat.
Oh, right.
We've repurposed and we've turned it into the saddle. It's even got a pocket on it.
Quite unique, isn't it?
Yeah, it's lovely. Nice little touch. Yes. And there's been quite a bit of interest.
Looked off you 1,800.
You do 19?
No, I'm afraid 18's my top limit. Take it or leave it, Mike.
So £1,800, but you'll take it today?
I will, yes, £1,800.
Bike's yours.
Well done.
Just got yourself a nice little bike.
Lovely, thank you very much.
Well done.
Brilliant.
Well, the little Honda motorbike is now sold. And to be honest with you, sad to see it go. Sort of grew fond of that, but the money is in the bank, and now we can move on.
Click here to subscribe.